Good morning, good morning. Goeiemôre aan elkeen van u. Het is een nieuwe dag, het is die 2 juli. En ik wil vir elkeen sê, goeiemôre. Selamat sore, untak, teman teman, saya di Indonesië. To all my Indonesian friends, what a privilege this morning. It's cold in South Africa. A privilege to sit around the word with you. This morning I just want to encourage you. I want you to turn to 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 1 and 2. And we read the following in 1 Kings chapter 18. And it says in verse 1, quite some time later, 3 years later, a message from the Lord came to Elijah, go visit Ahab and I'll send some rain to the surface of the ground. So Elijah went to show himself to Ahab right when the famine in Samaria was most severe. And yes, I believe famine is the absence of rain. Famine is the absence of rain. And we see here that famine is actually what's happened in this place. I'm asking you this morning about your dry place. I'm asking you this morning about the area of your life where you've prayed, where you're fasting, where the area of your life where you struggle. We're in a pandemic, and most of this pandemic actually show areas of our lives that we're lacking. And we see here that there was famine, but there was a promise in verse 1. It says that God sent Elijah and he said, I will send you some rain. So first, I want you to understand something. Before a dry place and rain can happen, there must be a promise. And I believe God has a promise for you this morning on the 2nd of July. I believe this is a new season. Then I want to go to 1 Kings chapter 18, but verse 42. Actually, verse 43. So understand, this whole process that happened until we get to this place. God said, I will send rain. But there's a whole process of things that happened. But when we come to verse 43, it says the following. Then he told his young servant. So in verse 42, we see that Elijah said to Ahab, got up to get something to eat and drink while Elijah went back up to the top of the Mount Carmel where he bowed low to the ground and placed his face between his knees. He positioned himself in an humbleness before God to pray for rain. And as he prayed, in verse 43 we read, then he told his young servant, go and look toward the sea. So he went and looked out to the sea, and he said, nothing there, he said. Now, I want to stop there first. So, we see there's a promise, and then we see there's the moment, the season, the situation, where Elijah bowed his head and started to pray. So, he kept on praying. So, when he said, servant, do you see any sign? He said, I don't see anything. Today we find many people, I do a lot of counseling and you will find people but will say, Pastor, but I already prayed about this. I already prayed. How come my situation did not change? How come I don't see the hand of God? How come my dry place, the rain that is promised not yet start to fall? So he said, Elijah, when he prayed, he sent his servant out to look for a sign. Now, what does it mean? A sign is a manifestation of a changed season. Important. So sometimes we have to look for the sign because also it means it's God's confirmation on what is promised. So sometimes we just pray and say, okay, God, but we don't persevere. We don't stick to it to look for the sign, the confirmation, the change of the season. I'm telling you, through faith, know God as the great I am. Yes, True faith is to persevere, is to stick. So he sent his servant and he said, he prayed again and he sent him out again. And he said to the servant, do you see any sign? And then the servant said, he went back and we read and then he said nothing. But Elijah told him to go back 7 times. My friend, you have prayed maybe for the last week, the last month, the last year, maybe even the last 3.5 years. I'm asking you today, do you see the sign or do you see any sign? Sometimes the problem we face is the focus. We pray, but we're not focused. We're not zoomed in for something that God is telling us during this situation. I want to encourage you today. Maybe you've prayed like Elijah. You really went on your knees and you have this, you know, prayer conversation with God. And then you get up and you have an expectation. But sometimes we stop there. We stop at the moment because we do not see anything. Or we just stop and we say, well, okay, maybe God has heard. But we see in Elijah, he sent out the servant until. I want you to repeat after me. You see, it's until you see the sign, until you receive the peace of God in your spirit, until you know that something has shifted, until the moment you discover the joy of God within you. You see, there's a sign. And my question this morning is, maybe you've prayed. I challenge you today to go out and look for a sign. You see, I will keep on looking. I will keep on knocking. I will not let it go until I know that there's a sign and there's a promise. Because the promise already God gave. God said He will bless you. God said He will bring healing to your body. God said He is the provider of your needs. The promise is there, just like Elijah. Even God gives the promise, we see in verse 43, that he had to pray until he saw the sign. And the moment the sign happened, the manifestation of the promise actually started to manifest in the natural. I'm telling you today, I'm really challenging you. You know, when you pray, go out. Go again. Don't just let it go. Look for the sign. Maybe there's sickness. I want to tell you, be healed in Jesus' name. But you know what? The word will work until it fulfills. But sometimes there's a sign to show you there's a change that's happening. I want to speak over your finances. And I said, may the blessing of God prosper you. May the seed that you've sown just come in abundance into the fullness, into fruitfulness. And may the rain just fall upon that. And once again, the word will work until it fulfills. And I'm telling you, we need sometimes to persevere. Go out again. Maybe recheck your medical results. Check your bank account or check your relationship. Whatever there is, a dry place. When you've prayed and when you've experienced, there's a change. And that change is like a sign. You will see the promise of God manifest. And I'm telling you, sometimes we just have to look up. We're so focused on the natural. We're looking just in the natural. But sometimes God just wants to say, look up, and you will see. And the servant went out 7 times. He went out as Elijah told him. And then we get to verse 44. On the 7th look, he said, look, there's a cloud, a small one, about the size of a man's hand. It's coming up out of the sea. And then he said, get up and find Ahab. Elijah said, tell him, mount your chariot and ride down the mountain so the storm doesn't stop you. My brother and sister, I want to tell you, if you have obedience, if you have your faith, if you have persevered, don't give up. Because it's your faith in God, knowing that He loves you. It's the faith that you have and you hold on to the promise that makes you to say, you know what, I will not give up. I will hold on. And I'm telling you today, I'm really releasing this word over your life today, over your dry places. I want to pray for you and say, God, send the rain. God, but show the sign of your promise. And God really is a true God. He's a loving God. But sometimes we just give up too early. We just lose our faith. We say, well, I've tried. No. If your faith is true, you will persevere. You will hang on. You will release the word of God over your situation. So I'm challenging you today, even after this message, just pray and say, God, send your rain. I stand on the word of God. I stand on your promise. And I will not let it go, even if I have to go out and look for a sign. Because once again, the sign is a confirmation of what God has promised. A sign is also a confirmation, not a confirmation, but a manifestation of a changed season. And I challenge you, we are on the second part of this year. And once again, God wants to do something new in your life. So I want you to look. You know, if we look at the cross, we see a sign. And that sign tells us that Jesus has died for you. That sign, when you look at the cross, it says, through his stripes, there's healing for you today. When we look at the cross and we see it's empty, we see the resurrection Jesus Christ having the power given unto you and me, given unto you and me the keys to open up, given unto you and me to conquer, but to stand in faith, and the promises being released in your life. So this morning, I really want to say, go out and receive now your breakthrough. Just receive in all your dry places that God will heal you. God will bring the change. I don't believe the word is just empty. I believe God has given me this word for you to change the atmosphere, to change what you experience, to know that something is about to happen, because the word of God is true. The word of God is bringing a change. So I really want to encourage you, and I really, really just want to tell you, you know what? Don't give up. Even you prayed, have an expectation. Have this thing in your heart that, God, I know that your word is true, and I want to encourage you today. May God bless you. Heavenly Father, I pray this morning for everyone that's watching this. I pray, Lord, I stand on the promise that you will send the rain. And now we come to this place where we actually pray and say, Lord, send the rain. Manifest your promise. Manifest your promise right now in all the areas in the lives of the ones listening. Lord, let them see the sign today. Let them see the power of God in action today. And therefore, Lord, I just release it. Change the atmosphere. Build them up. And let them just glorify you. We honor and worship you today in Jesus' mighty name. So I really want to bless you. And I just want to say, may you have an awesome day. And may God just show you his love through his son, Jesus Christ. To my Indonesian friends, I want to say Tuhan memberkatimu. To you, may God bless you all. Have an awesome time. And yeah, we will talk again. God bless you. Bye.